In this video, we're going to compare the Be Quiet Pure Rock Slim 2 to the CoolerMaster Hyper 212 using machine learning on over 1 million data points. The details in this video can also be found on my website at pcanalytics.com, and the product links can be found in the description below. With that in mind, let's look at some qualitative metrics. Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, neither cooler will have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, the Pure Rock Slim 2 uses a single 92mm fan, while the Hyper 212 uses a single 120mm fan, and it is possible to add a second fan on both coolers. In regards to installation, the Pure Rock Slim 2 is easy to install, while the Hyper Cooler installation is very involved, requires many steps, and can prove to be challenging for beginners. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds, and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the Pure Rock cooler in red to the Hyper 212 cooler in blue, both coolers perform similarly across the board in terms of cooling. However, given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the Hyper 212 cooling begins to outperform the Pure Rock cooler. When considering sound, the Hyper 212 becomes louder at higher RPMs. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that both CPU coolers have to run at high RPMs to keep up with the high heat load. For the next set of comparisons, we'll look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis while keeping temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that both coolers perform similarly across the board. As we increase the watts to 105, we can see that the Hyper 212 cooler begins to outperform at lower decimals, but the coolers perform similarly after about 34 decimals. As we increase the watts to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, the Hyper 212 cooler has slightly better cooling performance for a given percent speed. However, as we consider noise, we can see that the performance differences are negligible. With that in mind, the Pure Rock Slim 2 is the winner given that it gives the most bang for your buck. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.